We're on to old business. Local option sales tax renegotiation update from the county manager.
Chairman, members of the board, you may recall, June 26th work session, the board approved initiating renegotiations with the city for lost to begin June 27th, 2012. That's the first phase of negotiations, and it's called direct renegotiations, and that is for a 60-day period. Considering when the board approved these proceedings, this 60-day period ends August 26th. As required, the city and the state revenue commissioner were notified at that time that the county had in fact initiated the renegotiations. Since that time, county senior staff has met with city senior staff on June 29th, at which time we discussed the lost schedule framework on how to proceed with our meetings and continue to work on collection, assembling, and analysis of data using criteria and the criteria that's spelled out in some of the documents we have and others as determined by each side. We met a second time on July 18th, and at that time we discussed the county's intent to follow the Georgia Code and also to follow ACCG guidelines when considering and analyzing and discussing data and the eight criteria. At that time, the county shared a preliminary worksheet with the eight criteria with the comments, and that is part of the package that you have in front of you this evening. Also at that meeting, the city did share with us their position regarding the percentage of split, and we had some discussion regarding that percentage as well. We have not met since that time. However, on August 10th, we exchanged some additional information with the city. The county provided to the city service delivery budgeted cost worksheet that is also part of your package. And that simply shows the cost for each government to provide the service delivery responsibilities to both the city and the county, in this case, this being the county. At that time, the city provided us with a document, and that document also was in your package, and that document basically summarizes their position on a few items that they spell out. One is the central business district, the other is lowering property tax burden and daytime population. That's the only document that we've gotten from the city to date to work from. The current status is, for at least from my perspective, unless we get directive other than this from the board, is that we will continue to collect data and analyze data. We are, however, approaching the deadline for renegotiating the split during the first phase of this process. Again, that process is known as direct renegotiation. That process, as I mentioned earlier, ends August 26th. The recommendation at this point is for the board to simply consider preparation to advance to the next phase, and that next phase of negotiation is known as alternate dispute resolution, and you may know it as being a non-binding mediation phase. Unless, of course, you believe an agreement can be reached with the city prior to the deadline of August 26th. If an agreement is not reached during the first phase, which we are in today, direct renegotiations, then law requires that parties submit immediately to non-binding arbitration, mediation, or another alternate dispute resolution. And again, that being the next phase, which is alternate dispute resolution. That phase as well is 60 days in length. And where we are today with respect to preparing for the next phase, if in fact this board would like to take action in that respect. Next step, would the board like staff to report on the work that's been done to date at an upcoming meeting? And also, would the board like to begin the process of discussing and selecting a mediator? I would assume that might be done at the county attorney level along with the city's attorney to discuss the selection of the mediator, if in fact you go in that direction. Chairman?
Yes, sir. Thank you. If I understood what you said towards the beginning there, I think I heard you say that at least cursory numbers, I assume, expressed as a percentage of the loss split, were discussed or mentioned by the city side of the conversation. Can you tell us what those numbers were?
I can. The city's position, at least at staff level, senior staff level, was a split for the city at a range between 15 and 25% of the split.
15 to 25% lost.
Yes, of the loss.
Of the loss, thank you. Yes. And on the other hand, or as a data point, let's say that as one data point, we have information here that shows that the tax digest value of all the property in the city of Cumming compared to the tax digest value, I guess, of everything in the county, yields a 3.94% of the value in view that way. Do I have that right?
You have it correct.
Okay. So the idea that we may go to negotiations or further is potentially incorporated or insinuated with the possible difference of 3.94% versus 15 to 25%. I'm not saying that that is the only way to look at it, but I'm saying with the information provided here, those are two gross, well-defined, although perhaps coarse data points to look at.
You are correct, and as you said earlier, that is one of the data points we would be evaluating. So.
Councilor, question, please.
Sir.
In the law that describes the negotiation, is there a difference on the definition of daytime or nighttime population? What does the law, how does the census view that population? Is there a difference for this?
Yeah, the actual statute does not speak in terms of daytime and nighttime population. And remember, when we sort of went through our, we had like two primers on loss. The eight criteria set forth are simply things to be considered, but it says are not limited to those things. So what I can tell you, Commissioner LeMann, is while the statute does not say daytime versus nighttime, to the extent that one party wanted to bring that issue to the table and say that is important to them, I don't think it would be by any stretch precluded or forbidden, but it is not spelled out specifically that is a factor to consider at all.
Populations are done by the census, correct?
They are.
And does the census have a separation of daytime or nighttime? Or do they just consider your residence where you live?
I believe it is simply a function of where there is residence, not as far as a daytime and nighttime population. But I was going to finish by saying, if you bear down into the data far enough, into some of the data points way down deep, it may very well, I'm not sure I'm qualified right now to say.
The Census Bureau does have they'll provide daytime and nighttime population. They do provide two formulas for arriving at that number.
Those formulas include weekends?
I don't think this gives a value of taking them through that ACS, the American Consumer Survey, Consumer Community Survey, and takes those numbers to the data.
So, Doug, what, if any, action are you asking from the board on this time?
The chairman, members of the board, I think it's imperative that, as we've talked many times, that you're aware of the schedule that we're on. My understanding from legal is that to move from the initial or the direct renegotiation, the first 60 days of renegotiation to alternate dispute resolution just happens. You automatically move into the next 60 days. However, considering that it is a non-binding mediation or arbitration or other form of dispute resolution, I would think that the county would want to be or prepare themselves for that mediation and perhaps do so at some point prior to that date or very close to that date, discuss the potential of bringing on a mediator or hiring a selective mediator.
Did the city offer in any way other evidence or evidence derived from the daytime, nighttime population that would suggest where on the split that they offered, I guess, was 12.5% to 25%, did I get that number right?
15 to 25%.
Why such a wide, that's almost 100%, or doubling, nearly a doubling of the low end number to arrive at the top end number. Any pointers as to what would cause a person to say, well, 15 looks a lot more right than 25?
Chairman, they did not. In fact, the meeting that we they provided the 15 to 25% different. In fact, from the information that you got here in this document, the third bullet point there is the daytime population. When they presented to us their range, there was no discussion at that time that I can recall about daytime population. If there was, it was not directly related to or associated with their range for the split.
And to your knowledge, does the county have any information that would indicate that 15 to 25% or some range in there is the better direction to go in?
The way I would answer that, Chairman, is to say that we continue to gather data. There are some documents and data that we've collected and analyzed that might suggest something quite different than that. But I'm not sure that we've got all the data points together that would point us in a direction that would give us any comfort in providing you with a position or recommendation. You realize and know that we've worked on this data. We have some data gathered. If the board would like us to share some of that data with you, I think they might be in a position to share some of that tonight. If not, we can certainly do that at another meeting, and hopefully by that time we will have gathered additional information.
Mr. Chair, I just wanted to mention to you along the lines of what the county manager just said. As we get closer to the automatic drop-off point to go into the formal mediation process, I think the work session would be in order to perhaps go through some of this in some roll the sleeves up detail, because there's a host of issues right now involved in the city of Cumming for which we need some movement.
Thank you. The board, the time frame we're looking at, I think we need to go ahead and get mediation scheduled. Let's start working on selecting a mediator. We're just 2 weeks away from about 2 weeks.
Yes, sir. And the city attorney and I have already had preliminary discussions along those lines.
Do we initiate mediation, or is it common just to?
It would be something that I would work with the city attorney to go ahead and set up, and obviously keep you intimately in the loop.
Split the cost with the city?
Of course.
Yes. I make a motion to that effect, voting with that strong.
I just wanted to be clear then, based on your answer, Doug, you're telling me if I go wrong, I'm interpreting your answer to mean that the county has not at this point found any numbers which lead us very close at all to the direction of even the bottom line of the 15%.
I wouldn't say that exactly, Chairman. I would say that with the information that we have today and to the extent we've evaluated it, it has not risen to the 15% split.
But do you have for a higher one?
I'm not sure that we have a high and low necessarily.
Mr. Chairman, can I second that for discussion?
Yes. We have a motion, we have a second for discussion. Thank you. Todd? You can continue if you want.
Yeah, I have a high and low.
Could I just caution, if we want mediation, that we, while we want to certainly keep the public the best of what we're discussing, I think it would be wise not to discuss everything that we might add in a public meeting if we're under mediation.
Maybe a high and low, I think it's reasonable.
Just as a...
We don't have a high and low today. We just don't have that information.
But a low could possibly be a 3.94.
Well, the low could be zero.
He says he doesn't have it today.
The low could be zero, the high could be 100.
I mean, there's no pressure for the maximum we'll have.
I think that we need to, again, be cautious about what we, because this will be used in negotiations, and we certainly want to keep people aware of what we're doing. We certainly don't want to lay our entire thought processes and strategies out on the table.
I don't know, the strategy maybe, but we'll either have some numbers or we won't.
Well, if they, if you're the party that you're going to be mediating with, looks at the type of questions that are being asked here, they will have a better opportunity to create answers favorable to them in the mediation session.
All right. Well, we had discussed having a work session to go over these, but now I'm confused as to whether that's within the strategy that's being contemplated or not.
Mr. Chairman, what I'm hearing is I don't think that the motion by Commissioner Bell precludes the work session. I think what I'm being provided is the authority to begin taking concrete steps to set up the formal mediation as soon as the date is triggered.
That's what I second.
Right. However, the issue of putting this on a work session is something a person could also make a motion for here, I would expect.
Yeah.
And that's where my confusion comes in. Okay, so let's...
I think he's asking, do we want to do that, or do we want to do this or that? Ken, what would you suggest? I mean, do we want a work session? I would
recommend we do both. I mean, just because I've been given authority to set up mediation protocols, I mean, that doesn't have to occur on August 28th. That can still occur sometime in September. That gives me a comfort level to go ahead and start actually calling up mediators and getting their price sheets in and that sort of thing. Mr. Chairman, I hardly recommend we still do the work session.
Well, we can do both. I mean,
there's no
problem doing both. We have him start working on mediation now, and when next work session we put it on.
And we have some time to think about how we need to present. And so,
I'll agree with you. Needless to say, you probably have a high level then, so we'll be discussing how prospective and how you can do that now. Eventually, we'll talk about
it. We've already spoken that day, yes.
Well, right. Then on the motion as it stands to approve the county attorney beginning mediation protocol, is that the...
That's it. I'm not picking a date. I'm simply moving the process forward. That's all.
And then we've supported one of the last couple of seconds, which I've just put on the work session. I think we need a motion to that.
Fair enough. On the motion then to be for the county attorney to begin the mediation protocol, if there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion.
If you want to put it on work session, I'll be having a second.
I would like to go ahead and put it on the next work session.
Next work session is August 28th. Well, that's after the second round has already started. Do you want to maybe do it earlier than that? But that would be a special call meeting or special call work session.
I would be happy to have a special call board meeting session on this. Somebody want to propose a date?
I don't know if it'll work with the board, but I would simply request that you look at a date later in the week. That would give us a little more time to prepare additional staff appointments.
Thursday
the 23rd.
What's the matter with just waiting until the 28th? I mean, 12 days gives them plenty of time to present. And if the counselor, unless the counselor has mediation set up, if we get mediation set up and we need to meet, he can contact all of us and we can set a meeting.
I mean, Ken says he's starting in September. Hopefully, he's working on information now.
That's right. I mean, giving me the point, go ahead into the mediation process is nice, but remember, we've got till almost November to get the mediation.
So we can do it on the 28th?
It will. Yes, sir.
It hasn't been looking for something that's had nothing with it. We can take some things off.
Wait till the 28th then?
Yeah, wait till the 28th.
Okay, so there, I was making a motion to withdraw it.
Gotcha.
We'll just have that, then on the regular meeting the 28th, we'll talk about this.
Work session.
Yeah. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, item number two was postponed.